Welcome back to Flat Hats at Home, bringing a little bit of Redwood National and State Parks to you and your home. For today's episode, we got special permission to bring you into the Redwood Forest to discover with us how redwoods are actually just a huge forest of clones. What do I mean by this? Let's patch over to Ranger Carla and find out.
Hi, my name is Carla and I'm an interpretation ranger at Redwood National and State Parks. Right now, I'm standing right by a group of really big redwood trees. If you were here last week, you know that often redwood seeds don't make it to maturity. So how do these 2,000-year-old trees pass on their ancient lineage?
Well, redwoods have a unique adaptation that allows them to reproduce in a different way. Redwood trees have the capability to clone themselves, which basically means that this tree, the parent tree, can replicate itself from suppressed or unsprouted burl tissue and form a clone when it's under some sort of stress.
Take a look at the bulbous, knobby growth on this redwood tree here. We refer to this as a burl or burl tissue. Burl tissue is where the dormant genetic information lives within the redwood tree. And it's also likely the location where a new sprout will form if the redwood tree is under some sort of stress. Redwood trees are one of the only conifers that are capable of producing clonal burls.
If you investigate a redwood burl closely, you might be able to spot sprouting apex buds or even adventitious roots. These roots can stabilize themselves in the soil around the base of the tree and form a new clone.
There are many environmental stressors that can initiate the growth of a redwood clone.
Whether it's a windstorm causing extensive tree damage, or a wildfire that smolders a tree from within, or even human-induced tree removal. These stressors will force a tree to send a chemical signal to the dormant bud tissue in the tree, and out comes a sprout.
Occasionally, an almost perfect circle of redwood trees sprouts out from one parent tree. We refer to these structures as catherdral trees, or fairy rings. As you can see here, this entire stand of redwoods is connected from the root system of one parent tree, likely that burnt out, hollowed out redwood that you see back here. If you can believe it, cloning is the primary method of reproduction for these redwood trees. It's just one of the many adaptations that these trees have that allow them to live for such a long time. Back to you, Ellie.
Thanks, Ranger Carla. Pretty amazing stuff, huh? Come back next week and we're going to dive into the rivers and oceans with Ranger Laura, and we're going to discover the amazing journey of a super important species here at Redwood National and State Park. Any guesses what it is? Thank you so much for watching this week's episode of Flat Hats at Home, bringing just a little slice of Redwood National and State Parks from our home to yours. If you enjoyed this video, give us a like or maybe even give us a share. Redwood National and State Parks is committed to bringing as much of our park to your home as we can during this unprecedented time. So please stay healthy and stay safe.